East Coast RC, Mark. So just been out having a bash session, and we've still got the problem with the car going into a limp mode. Now I'm using these Gen's Ace 5000 milliamp 50C 3S lipos, and I've got three of these. This one is pretty straight. The other two, I've got a slight kink to them. Now whether this is through the batteries or the motor or the ESC causing them to overheat, if anybody can give me a heads up on that, comment down below please. Like I say, I'm new to this, and I'm just trying to get my head around the whole running of the cars, the batteries, and what it is that my Armor Big Rock is going into this limp mode. But the new Armor BLX 3S 3660 motor into it, and yeah, I mean, it was running for a bit, but then it still seems to go into the limp mode. The ESD starts having a red flashing light on it, and I've seen it on YouTube, they call it the flashing light of death. So whether that needs to get a new one and get that sent off and order a new piece, I think it's probably going to be my next stage. We're just going to go through stripping down the gears again, just because I was making some weird cogging noise. I hope they haven't stripped again, because it's going to be 2 weeks in a row now of just, like, it's about the third set of gears. I ain't even had a chance to even run through three batteries yet. Sorry guys, just had to shoot off. My horse just won on the National, so get in. Right, where was we? Getting this motor out, didn't we? Okay guys, so I think with where he's losing the drive, where I'd set the new spur gear to the pinion, the mesh, which apparently is the gap in between, has slightly moved. Whether that's because the teeth have obviously just worn a little, and that's caused that bit more rocking, that's spinning it without. Yeah, it's so spinning it. So all we've got to do, we've got to just adjust these two locking nuts, which is holding the aluminium housing. And just adjust that spur gear slightly over to the pinion, and hopefully that will prevent the spinning, and we'll get the four-wheel drive back again. it wrong, guys, please let me know, because obviously, like I say, I am new to this, so I'm just trying to blag my way through it. But, you know, as life is, learn from your mistakes. There's rear diffs, guys. As you can see, you know, one side turns, the other side does the both spin. Coming from the central dry shaft, that'll spin. And then, as I can easily see that in here, we've got some plastic shavings, which is never a good sign. So, obviously, one of the teeth is stripped in here. So, that's another eBay job. We'll get that stripped down and have a good look in there, see what's going on. But there you have it, guys. Smooth as butter. Completely shot. That's another order. Just to get things here and hopefully get running, because it's just, you know, it's now got 3 weeks of not being able to actually go out and properly run it. It's just consistent every week, something wrong. It's great fun when they work, when they start. In bits. Just go and get some bits ordered and we'll catch you next time, hopefully on the build. Alright, I'm Mark. Stay safe. Peace out.